What's good, YouTube? This video is going to be about a huge turnoff and a huge red flag for guys. Now, all you ladies that like to get really drunk and really high at parties and out at bars, this one's for you. Men can't stand to see a woman who's chosen to get too drunk or too high or too loaded at a party. Whether you're on pills, whatever your drug of choice is, whatever your number of choice is, men can't stand to see that. And it's one of the least attractive things that we can see you doing. If there's a list, if there's like a top 10 list of things, the ugliest things that you can see a woman doing, it's getting too high. High is like at least one or two. And this is for a lot of reasons. I know a lot of guys get high, and again, that can seem like a double standard. But again, you set your own standards. So it's not a double standard because you don't have some, but other people have them for you, right? Get some standards of your own if you're a person who thinks that that's a double standard, because it shouldn't be. Anytime you see somebody out of control, drunk out of their mind, high out of their mind, and that's how they have to party, it's a problem. But women specifically look very terrible doing this because of the risk factors involved in getting too drunk and too high at parties. There are 6 reasons why we hate to see women like this, and why we think it's super unattractive, and why we also might question whether or not we should even date a woman who does this in public. Any man with some sense, any man who takes love seriously, any man who takes life seriously will probably have a problem with this. And these are the 6 reasons why. The first reason of which is clearly your decision making. Your decision making is in question when we see you making terrible decisions, and it is a terrible decision for a woman to be too drunk or too high at a party. Most of the time, women find themselves alone and in compromised positions when they get too drunk and too high, and I know y'all come to parties in groups, but somehow or another, a woman always gets separated from the herd when she's that slow. Too many things can happen, too many things have happened, and too many things happen on a regular basis to women for you to ever put yourself in this compromising position. And in, a man with any sense is going to look at this and be like, nah, I can't do that, right? Because eventually you'll get yourself into a position that he either has to get you out of or he has to avenge for you. He has to question your decision-making ability, because there's nothing safe or smart about getting too drunk or too high at parties. The question of how seriously you take your safety and how strong your self-protective instincts are, right? Those are important to a guy because, again, a lot of things happen that men have to go do something about. He doesn't want to be put in a compromised position because you make shitty decisions. A man wants to protect you. He wants to love you. He wants to care for you. But he doesn't want to have to do that despite you destroying your own life and putting yourself in dangerous situations. So regardless of what you think men are looking at when you're the fun version of you, sometimes you're actually telling a man that you don't protect yourself and that he's going to have to protect you or try to get you to protect yourself. And convincing a woman to do anything different than what she wants to do is always going to be very difficult. He doesn't want you to change because of him. He wants you to naturally be self-protective, naturally be wise and make good decisions. So this is always a problem. Moving on. The second reason why guys hate women who get too drunk and too high at parties is, or the second reason they think it's unattractive is, how trustworthy are you? If you can't trust yourself to protect yourself, then how can I trust you to protect our relationship with the conduct that you display when you're drunk and high? You can't trust yourself to not humiliate and embarrass yourself in public being drunk or high. When you're my woman and you go out in public and you have a couple of drinks and you choose to have a couple of more drinks and choose to have a couple of more drinks, pretty soon you're humiliating me. You're doing something that represents our relationship wrong and in the wrong light. And again, you've put yourself in a compromising position. So not only are people going to look at me like, bro, she got a boyfriend. What he about? What he think about this? But again, can I trust you since you're so out of control? Can I trust your decision making? Can I trust that you won't cheat? Can I trust that you won't make out with guys? Can I trust that you won't be dancing on people all nasty? And again, projecting sexual energy out to people who don't deserve it, who don't need it because they're not me, your man. Because you're too drunk, you're too high, you're too out of control at this party. What's the number one excuse in the world for a guy who cheats all the time? I was drunk. I was high. You know, I was that. We hear that all the time. We know people lean on those substance abuse issues to say or to excuse themselves from cheating. So when I see a woman and when men see a woman who can't hold their liquor or who's not choosing to hold their liquor or who's not choosing to smoke less or who's not choosing to engage less or at all, even we assume that we may be hearing those same types of excuses from her when she's practiced some infidelity of sorts. So it's always just a little bit scary. Moving on. The third reason why guys don't like this is a person who overindulges and has no self-control can be very hard to guide or lead. And as a man, you want to be able to guide and you want to be able to lead your spouse when necessary, as they guide and lead you when they are more equipped and they are more knowledgeable and they're more aware of things, right? Leadership is something that is shared between a couple who respects each other. But if a woman displays that she has no self-control, you can't trust her to help you, and you damn sure can't trust that you'll be able to help her, because she might not be in a position that she listens to anyone. If she can't control herself, what makes you think you can help guide her or lead her? Not in a possessive sense, but in a protective sense. People who lack self-control often also have trouble with boundaries and rules and standards of any kind. They find themselves to be rebels, and I don't need you rebelling against our relationship. Your lack of self-control will cause us a lot of issues, and not just at parties. The fourth reason why we don't like party girls, we don't like the super drunk, super high girl, and we probably won't talk to you or take you seriously if we see you that way, is this. Sometimes we see you getting too drunk or too high at parties as insecure. Sometimes we wonder why you felt the need to get that drunk, why you had to be that plastered to have a good time or be your confident self, why it takes those substances for you to feel comfortable around people. What insecurities are you battling? And what insecurities are going to start to affect our relationship if we take those substances away, or if we agree that we won't do that anymore? What insecurities, what mental distress are we going to have to deal with? Because sometimes people are doing that because they need to do that to get over their anxieties, right? And I understand that, but sometimes that can be a lot to deal with, especially when that person doesn't have that option, right? And we don't understand if you're covering up insecurities, if you're covering up social anxiety, we don't know what it is. So it's always a question of your confidence as a person. It's always a question of your self-concept. We have to think about those things, the backstory, the whys behind some of your actions. And that just makes us question your confidence and your insecurity. With that said, the fifth reason why we don't think that's a good idea is kind of the same, but different. Are you self-medicating? When I see a woman getting too drunk or too high or not controlling herself or choosing not to control herself, I have to wonder if she's self-medicating, if there's something in her life that she's trying to escape from, if there's a history, a traumatic past, a traumatic present that she's trying to escape from. It basically says, I can't handle life and I need this substance. I need this party. I need this moment. I need this fun to get over things, to get through things, to numb myself. When I see a woman getting too drunk and too high, and I speak to a lot of guys about this, when we see this shit, we wonder if a woman is self-medicating because there's a lot of drama in her life. And a lot of men are trying to avoid drama at all costs, especially a man who's looking for love. Seriously, we don't want no drama. But if it looks like you're trying to escape from something, if it looks like this is your numbing time and your numbing mechanism is going to parties and wilding out, we don't want to be a part of whatever you're trying to wild out from. And usually that's the lifestyle that a person is going to inherit when they get with a person who has these types of issues. There are a lot of great things you can do if you're going through mental health issues. There are a lot of great programs that you can join as far as recovery and building self-confidence and getting coaching about your anxieties and getting counseling about and therapy about your anxieties and your fears and your insecurity and your toxic background. But getting too drunk and plastered at parties and then not protecting yourself and living a dangerous life on the wild side is not one of those things. So if we see that, we always wonder if one of those are the case. Last but not least, the sixth reason we don't like women who get too drunk and too high at parties and make a fool out of themselves is we just have to assume that you're that girl. You're that party girl. You're that girl that goes to parties, picks up guys, gets taken home and gets plastered and gets banged into couch cushions. We have to assume that. Men don't like the party girl. They enjoy her, and the men who don't want relationships love taking home the party girl. But for the most part, men don't trust the party girl. The party girl is just like the F-boy or any other player that you see. You have to imagine that she encounters a lot of guys at parties and a lot of alcohol is being thrown, a lot of drugs are being taken, and she's not controlling herself because you're witnessing it right now. So why wouldn't she go home with somebody? Why wouldn't she be collecting bodies on a regular basis? For a guy who's serious about relationship, he doesn't want his woman to be under somebody because she met him at a party and she had a couple of drinks. People aren't looking for the Jerry Springer type relationships that some of you are promoting through your actions and through your behaviors. You are just projecting that you might be an unstable and or a very destructive type of girlfriend sometimes, and we don't want any part of it. The party girl is not trustworthy because the party girl is akin to the player from men's perspective. We know that the party girl encounters a lot of guys. We know that she dances with a lot of guys, and we know that she most likely sleeps with a lot of guys. It can be assumed, and it would be assumed, that she has a lot of one-night stands. Whether or not that's accurate, it doesn't matter. You're making a display of your ability to throw caution to the wind, and we have to take that into account when we choose you as a woman. We have to take that into account when we think about the relationship that we could have with a woman who throws caution to the wind. On top of our inability to protect her from herself, we can't protect our relationships because she might not place any sanctity on her own safety, let alone the safety of our hearts. So anyway, those are the 6 reasons why men do not like the women who get too drunk and too high at parties and are caught in compromising positions or seen not in control of themselves under the influence of substances. So anyway, do with that what you will. I hope that helps. Follow me at KFA24 on Instagram. I'll get with y'all later.